While in Nagasaki, Pope Francis visited one of the most sacred places for Christians in the country, Nishizaka Hill. This is where the first Japanese Jesuit, St. Paul Miki, and 25 other Christians were martyred and crucified in 1596. This grand monument with life-size statues celebrates their memory and keeps them as an example for others, because they died forgiving their assassins. The Pope put a wreath of flowers in front of the relics.
Que no sea una gloriosa reliquia de gestas pasadas, bien guardada y honrada en un museo, sino memoria y fuego vivo del alma de todo apostolado en esta tierra, capaz de renovar y encender siempre el celo evangelizador. Que podamos cada día librarnos de todo aquello que nos pesa e impide caminar con humildad, libertad, parresía y caridad.
The Pope also remembered the rest of the martyrs and the thousands of Christians that are persecuted or harassed for believing in God today.
Recemos por ellos y con ellos. Levantemos la voz para que la libertad religiosa sea garantizada para todos y en todos los rincones del planeta. Y levantemos también la voz contra toda manipulación de las religiones.
The rain at the end of the tribute was not overwhelming, so Pope Francis was able to say personal goodbyes to some of the people before leaving.
Rome Reports is now available on your TV. Thanks to our new app, Rome Reports Premium, you can watch exclusive content, documentaries, special reports, analysis, and more. You'll be able to access Rome's most recent news, now in HD and without commercials. Download the Rome Reports app in English or in Spanish. It's available on Apple TV, Roku, Amazon Fire, and Android TV.